Hello learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. I'm Nishant Sharma and today we'll be starting with lesson 21, Advertising and Salesmanship of your course Business Studies. There are four major topics that we'll be covering in today's video, which are advertising, publicity, sales promotion and salesmanship. To begin with advertising, you must have come across various ads on metro platforms, on radios, on FM, on TV channels. So when we talk of advertising, it is a tool which is used to inform and to motivate the existing and the prospective buyers to try and buy products of your company. Products may range from smartphone, gadgets, electronic devices, or even your fast moving consumer goods. For example, toothpaste, soap, brushes, hair oil, even your clothing. The question is how this information reaches to the masses. Obviously, with the use of media channels like TV, radio, Facebook, and even your WhatsApp. If we talk of understanding what advertisement or advertising actually means, it is a paid form of communication. By paid form of communication, we mean that the advertiser or the sponsors actually have to shell money out of their pockets in order to make sure that the information reaches to the target audience. It is also a non-personal presentation of message wherein the presenter or the advertisers do not come in direct contact with the target audience. There is a screen or a hoarding, but there is no face-to-face interaction between the sponsors and the target audience. The purpose of advertising also includes the promotion of goods and services that actually is the main and the sole objective of indulging into advertisement process. Advertisement is done by identified sponsors. For example, as soon as you see an advertisement on TV, if it is an iPhone, you instantly get to know that it comes from a company called Apple. Another term which is closely related with advertising or advertisement is publicity. But as soon as you hear this term publicity, the word free, free and free should strike to your minds. Because advertisement, as we've just discussed, is a paid form of communication. On the other hand, publicity is done free of cost. Sponsors or companies do not finance publicity. Because it is not paid for, there is no control over the content of publicity. Therefore, it can either be positive or negative. A very small example is of Maggi that comes from the brand Nestle. When Maggi got a bad reputation, the bad reputation of Maggi also started impacting other items under the Nestle brand. There is a substantial difference between advertising and publicity, and the points of differences are as follows. If we talk of payment, advertisement is a paid form of communication, whereas publicity is done free of cost. If we talk of identification of the sponsors, in case of advertisement or advertising, you already know well in advance as to which company the product comes from. So the sponsors are identified. Whereas in case of publicity, because there is as such no sponsorship, identification of the sponsors is not known. If we talk of control over the content of the message, because advertisement is well thought of, it's well paid off. Therefore, advertisers or the sponsors have full control over what is being advertised. They can control the content of the message. However, since publicity comes from third parties, there is no such control over the content or the matter which is being advertised. If we talk of impact of advertising and publicity, advertisement, because of the control of the content, is expected to generate positive impact. But in case of publicity, because it is not financed, it is not paid for, the impact can either be positive or negative, as we just discussed the case of Maggi noodles. Any activity in business which is done with certain objectives in mind. Similar is the case with advertising, which is done with certain objectives in mind, wherein the first one is the introduction of a new product. As soon as a company comes up with a new product, the product needs to be made available to the public. Before that, the product is required to be made known to the public. And this process of making the product known to the public is done through advertising. Advertising also helps in increasing the sales of the existing products of the company by creating an impression in the mind of existing customers, and thereby helps in maintaining existing customers. In case of business or enterprises, it is not necessary only to capture and get new clients, but also to maintain the existing buyers of the organization, of the product of the organization. Advertisement also helps in creating and enhancing the brand image of the organization. For example, if some organization's product run into crisis and generates a negative image for the organization or for the other products under the umbrella of the organization, advertisement as a technique can be used to change the perception and the image of the company in the minds of the perceiver. Advertising as a process also helps in personal selling. For example, if you enter into a physical shop and the personal seller or the salesman approaches you, the chances are more that you will be inclined to buy a product which is well advertised, because the advertisement has already created an image, an impression in the minds of the buyers. Advertising offers advantages to manufacturers, to consumers, and to society as large. If we talk of advantages of advertising to manufacturers, firstly, they get an enhanced brand image, they get built goodwill, also they get enhanced clientele or a customer base, because the sole purpose of this activity of advertising is to get the information to the masses. If we talk of benefits to the consumers, the benefits of advertising to consumers is impacted in terms of information which reaches to them and enables them to buy products out of all available choices. Consumers are actually in a position to make informed buying decision. If we talk of benefit of advertising to society, society is made up of manufacturers, consumers, and all other sort of stakeholders. There are certain advertisements that carry positive message and thereby enhancing social values. For example, an advertisement campaign run by Government of India to avoid enhancement in population, to avoid female feticide, or to promote education of girl child. There are also certain limitations of advertising, wherein the first one is that advertising multiplies wants. There are certain products that you do not actually need, but when you see the advertisement on television on you, or you hear the advertisement on a radio set, you may be tempted to buy the product despite of the fact that you do not actually need it. And when you cannot afford the product because of the premiumness, you feel deprived of the product. Advertising also adds to the cost and price of the product. The hefty amount spent by the advertisers or the sponsors on the advertisement campaigns, the cost of such campaigns are ultimately transferred to the last purchaser, to the last buyer, or the consumer, as we call it in marketing. Whatever the amount of advertisement spent by the company will ultimately be recovered from the consumers of the product. And thereby, advertisement adds to the cost and price of the product. Advertising sometimes may also impact the system of the society by compromising with the values of a particular strata of the society. An advertisement campaign which enhances or promotes liquor or tobacco products or recreational drugs which are not otherwise needed may actually hamper the value system of the society. Advertisement may also result into a social waste if it does not increase the overall demand or if it does not generate demand at all. Researches in past have proven that most of the advertisements, even if they are likable to the consumers, do not necessarily result into sale. And if an advertisement campaign does not result into sale, the overall purpose of advertisement is defeated. Advertisement may also result into a situation like monopoly if giant organizations run huge marketing campaign, huge advertisement campaign smaller retailers or smaller organizations may run out of the business because they, because of limited resources, are not in a position to compete on this advertisement front with larger or huge organizations. Advertisement can be done through various media channels. By media channel, we mean the source or the form through which the message reaches to the buyer, the message reaches to the consumer. The media channels can be varied from television, from newspaper, radio, magazines, even movies. There are companies which are placing their products indirectly in certain movie scenes. Also, there are outdoor advertisements that you come across on railway platforms, on metro platforms, in buses, even on roads. The next component of marketing is personal selling, or simply called salesmanship. Salesmanship is a process through which the personal seller or salesman comes in direct communication or in direct contact with the prospect or the prospective buyer. In order to impact sales through personal selling, the salesperson has to go through a certain process, which is called the process of personal selling. Firstly, the salesperson has to identify the prospect. As soon as you enter into a shop, certain salesperson would greet you, would meet you, and would try to get in talk with him. Then the salesperson has to indulge into a pre-approach activity in order to decide what is the correct way of approaching a particular customer and should the customer be approached at all or not. And after approaching the customer, the salesperson is required to make the presentation or the demonstration of the product to tell him about the features of the product and why the consumer should actually be purchasing this particular product. The consumer may have certain queries, certain questions, also certain doubts about purchasing the product, and the salesperson is required to make him aware of all the qualities and sort out all his doubts. If everything goes okay, the sale may be impacted, but the function or the work of the salesperson does not come to an end. In order to make sure that the consumer comes back and buys the same product, you have to follow up with the customer through a system of feedback. In order to be a good salesperson, you have to have certain qualities. You have to have a good personalities, mental qualities, good behavior, and knowledge of the product, which is of utmost importance. Until the salesperson has thorough knowledge of the product which he is willing to sell, the sale cannot be impacted. Apart from having knowledge, the salesperson should also be able to communicate that knowledge to the consumer or the prospective buyer and be able to persuade him to buy the product, or if not buy, at least try the product of the company. The next tool that we have is sales promotion. Sales promotion is a very often done activity. Again, if you enter into a shop and you see certain offers, for example, if you buy 3 soaps, you get 1 soap free, or the buy one, get one offer. Sales promotion is done through offering discounts, offering certain extra quantity, or maybe chances to win grand prizes. Such activities are mostly done during the festival seasons of Diwali, Rakhi, Eid, and other festive seasons. So if we have to define sales promotion in simpler terms, all the activities other than advertising, salesmanship, and publicity can be categorized as sales promotion. Just like advertising, even sales promotion has certain objectives, which is more or less similar to the objective of advertising. Through sales promotion, we try to inform the customers about the product. We try to persuade them in buying the product. Sales promotion, if is done successfully, enhances the sales volume of the company. Sales promotion also serves as an incentive to the retailers to stock more and more products of this particular company that indulges into or that promotes sales promotion activities. Sales promotion also helps in creating a distinct product identity. As a consumer, we are more likely to purchase products that come with something extra in comparison to the products which are not offering this something extra. There is a substantial difference between advertising and sales promotion. If we start discussing the objective of the two activities, advertising or advertisement is done to create a favorable consideration for the product, whereas sales promotion is done to stimulate the customers or the consumers to buy, and if not buy, so to at least try the product. If we talk of impact or effect of advertising and sales promotion, advertising or advertisement is expected to have long-term effect or long-term impact on the minds of the buyers. Whereas in case of sales promotion, the impact is exhausted as soon as the sale is done. So in case of advertisement, the impact is really long-term. And in case of sales promotion, the impact or effect is short-term. Advertisement as an activity has to be done again and again in order to create an impression on the minds of the viewers or the perceivers. Whereas in case of sales promotion, it is an activity which is not very often done, but one time or two time in a particular year or so. What are the tools used in sales promotion? Sales promotion can be done through various channels or through various tools. For example, you can distribute free samples of the product in a scheme of try and buy. If the consumer likes the trial package, it is expected that the consumer would come back and purchase the larger quantity of the product. You can also offer them some price cuts or price offs. This is very often done. A product which was earlier selling for 100 rupees is now available at a discount of 10%. Therefore, you can buy the same quantity, same brand, same packaging and same product at a reduced price of rupees 90. Certain companies also offer exchange offers. A very simple example of exchange offer is if you are willing to buy a new mobile phone, companies would readily accept your old mobile phone and give you certain price cut in terms of exchange offer, and the new price of the new phone would be adjusted with the price of the exchanged old phone. Also, fair and exhibitions are used. A very classic example of such fair is trade fair. You just go there to roam with your friends, but ultimately you end up buying certain products. Also, certain manufacturers or companies offer money refund offer. A very simple example is buying online. If you purchase any product from any online retailer, you already pay money well in advance, or even if there is a cash on delivery, the product is received and the money is paid to the company. But if you do not like the product, you can always return the money back if it comes with a money back guarantee. Certain companies, in case of high value items, also provide you with deferred payment plans, or simply known as EMIs, or equally monthly distributed installments. If the product is of high value, for example, a car which costs the consumer at least 10 lakh rupees, the upfront amount that the consumer pays maybe is rupees 2 lakh only, and the rest of the amount of rupees 8 lakh may be paid in equal monthly installments. Before we wind this video up, a quick recap of what we have discussed so far in this lesson. We've discussed the four components through which sale can be increased. We've discussed advertising and publicity. Advertising, again, as we just discussed, is a paid form of communication, and apart from being a paid form of communication, it is a non-personal way of informing. On the other hand, publicity is free form of communication, but it is not done directly by the sponsors. Rather, it is done by third parties beyond the control of the manufacturer or the company. We also discussed the objectives, advantages, limitations, and media of advertising. We also discussed personal selling or salesmanship, wherein the personal seller or the salesperson comes in direct touch and indulges into direct communication with the prospect or the prospective buyer. But in order to be a successful salesperson, the person is required to have certain qualities which we have already discussed in the previous slides. We also discussed sales promotion as a tool to promote sale on a particular point of time. We also discussed the objectives of sales promotion. We also discussed the difference between advertising and sales promotion. We also talked about tools which are used in sales promotion activities, offering discounts, contests, exchange offers, giving coupons to the buyers. And with this, we conclude today's lecture, today's video. Thank you so much. I wish you all happy learning.